This is your dose of daily market wisdom with Master Trader Nick Santiago. Starting from humble beginnings, Nick has been beating the markets for over two decades. He shares with you his take on the profitable trades that will have you moving towards financial freedom in no time at all. To see an in-depth review of his track record and much more, go to inthemoneystocks.com.
Welcome. This is your daily dose of daily market wisdom with Master Trader Nick Santiago. I'm Kerry Lutz. Today is 10/13/21, show number 330. Well, Nick, hey, it's Whipsaw Wednesday, but let's talk about precious metals prices. You know, it looks like we hit a capitulation point a few weeks ago. What's going on there?
Well, we got a great move in gold today and silver as well. I mean, the precious metals are on fire. When you look at gold futures, though, up 35 points right now, trading at around 1795. And, you know, just yesterday we were talking about the pattern was not broken and it still suggested a move to 1800. I think we might get there today. Now, the key level is going to be 1810 on a weekly chart close. Should gold futures close above 1810, then the next level, the next suggested level is going to be 1865. So there's some upside potential here. Really, really good action today for gold. This is what we call a breakout pattern. The volume is good as well. It's just got all of the typical moves of a breakout here today. So very, very good action.
All right. Well, that's what we like to see. And hey, when you're looking at the metals, we're also approaching a seasonally significant time of the year, fourth quarter, Q4. Usually we see the rally at the end of the year, especially because in the mining stocks, and I know you don't like look at this necessarily, a lot of tax loss selling took place in the summer rather than in Q4.
Well, that certainly could be the case. The miners are on fire today. You have the GDX up over 3%. GDXJ, which is a junior miners, the smaller guys, they're up 3.4%. So they're really improving a lot today, and that's a really, really good move. Now, the miners, just so everybody knows, there's a lot of resistance still in play coming up on the GDX, probably around 3250 and then more at 33. But very, very good price action today in them as well. So, I mean, I like to see the miners start to show leadership. If they can do that, that means gold has more legs, precious metals have legs. We always want to see the miners lead the metal. But very good job today. They're doing really, really well.
All right. And the broader market's getting whipsawed. We see this constantly, and really nothing to see here. It's Options X.
It's Options X, and this is Whipsaw Wednesday. Whipsaw Wednesday is usually the most choppy session ahead of the options expiration, which is on Friday, the 15th of October. And when you look at the price action today, we started out the day pretty strong, had a big, big sell-off. We went sharply lower. Now we're rebounding quite a bit. And, you know, it's just going to be that kind of day. Rallies will be faded and sell-offs will be met with new rallies. So just expect that really throughout the session. And maybe we'll even see some of that tomorrow. But Whipsaw Wednesday is usually the more pronounced day of whipsaw and choppiness.
Hey, so I wanted to talk about a stock we haven't mentioned recently, Tesla. It broke 800. Even today, it's on its way up. Is that a function of Whipsaw Wednesday and Options X, or is it breaking out?
No, it could be a function of options expiration. If a lot of people got bearish on this name a week or so ago, you know, then there could have been it could be something to do with options X. But overall, the Tesla pattern, believe it or not, is in an uptrend, and it's kind of been that way really since the middle of September or late September. So, you know, I got to give it the upside bias at the moment. There'll be some backing and filling. But it's above its 20-day moving average. It's above its 50-day moving average. And it actually got above a major pivot from April of 2021. So now you have the resistance level going all the way back to February of 2021. So there's some resistance in here now, but Tesla's still a strong name right now, and that should be respected.
Yeah, and it is really kind of becoming the new bellwether stock.
It really is. And it's a market leader, obviously. It's a market darling is what we call it. That's a term we used to use in the 90s when a stock was loved by the public. And this is definitely a market darling, but it's also an institutional favorite. So right now it's holding up well, and I don't see a big issue with it, but there is resistance in place, but it's definitely a bellwether stock now.
All right. Well, interesting times ahead of us here. Bitcoin is fading a little bit.
Yeah, Bitcoin was down earlier. It's actually come back now. It's a little bit above the flat line, but it was down earlier. Now I think it's up $300 or so. And Bitcoin's holding up well. I mean, it's not having the day gold is having, but it's had a big move as of late. And, you know, a lot of these so-called market talking heads call it the new gold. I don't believe that for 1 minute. But Bitcoin's hanging in there well, and the chart is actually pretty decent right now.
All right. Well, I think that's it for today then. But the gold is on fire, and we'll see. It's so close to the 1800s now. Your guess, it's going over 1800.
I think we're going to go test probably the 1810 level. We might even do it today. We're at 1795, 1796 as we speak, but I think it could do that. Now, the big key, remember what I just said earlier, is a close above 1810 on a weekly chart basis. That puts it in play to get to 1865. So let's see if that can happen. And, you know, I got a little gold coin on my desk as we speak. So I'd like to see that.
All right. You're not alone, that's for sure. Make sure you go over to inthemoneystocks.com, see how Nick has been beating the averages for decades. The Twitter feeds at ITMS, at NickSantiago01, at Kerry Lutz. Emails are always welcome at KL@KerryLutz.com. Nick, we'll talk to you on Friday.
Sounds good, Kerry.
This is your dose of daily market wisdom with master trader Nick Santiago. Starting from humble beginnings, Nick has been beating the markets for over two decades. He shares with you his take on the profitable trades that will have you moving towards financial freedom in no time at all. To see an in-depth review of his track record and much more, go to inthemoneystocks.com.